jQuery has some nice built-in methods to allow us to animate the transition of content. But one of the limitations of these built-in methods are that they're not customizable. What happens if we want to animate the transition of content in a way that's not simply fading in, fading out, or sliding up or down? In those instances, we can use jQuery's built-in animate function. This allows us to customize the behavior of an animation. To illustrate this, I've updated our index.html file to include a button with an ID of animate and a div element with an ID of myDiv. I've also set an initial styling of that element with a background color of hex code 333, a height of 150 pixels, and a width of 150 pixels. Let's go to our app.js file to see how we can use jQuery's animation function to customize the behavior of the transition. The animate function accepts an object containing the properties that we want to set in the animation, followed by the speed at which we want to animate. That speed can either be a string, like slow or fast or medium, or it can be a value representing the number of milliseconds we'd like the animation to take. Let's go to the browser to see how this animation looks. And when we click on the animate button, we see that we gradually increase the margin of our element as well as the height and width of our element. We can animate essentially any property of an element using the animate function in jQuery, but take careful note of the fact that unlike CSS, where separate words are separated by a dash, in the animate function in that object we pass in, they need to use camel case notation. In this example, we've set the values of each of our properties as absolute values, but we can also use relative values using the appropriate assignment operators. In this implementation, rather than setting absolute values, we simply increment or decrement the values of the properties that we want to animate. Of course, given our initial values and the values we specify to increment by, the animation should be the same as when we used absolute values. Let's go to the browser to make sure that's the case. And indeed, when we click the animate button, it animates it the same way that it did when we used absolute values. But when we click the animate button again, it further animates it. This is because we're using relative values, so it'll always increment that value, as opposed to when we use absolute values, it animates it there once, but then it doesn't do it again because those values are already set. This is something to be aware of as you use relative values in your animations. One thing that's really cool about jQuery animations is that we can chain them, meaning we can create a sequence of animations to take place one right after the other. Here, I've created a sequence of animations that I'm not going to walk through exactly what they do, but each animation will last 1 second, and then the next animation will take place. Let's go back to our browser to see what happens. When we click animate, our div kind of expands and contracts and adds margin and removes margin to form a sort of snake behavior. That's pretty cool. And those are just individual animations being called one right after another. So hopefully this is getting your creative juices flowing even more. Please take time to play around with these animation features, and we'll see you in the next section.